Saudi Arabia this morning is rejecting a 60 Minutes report about a classified document that may prove a Saudi link to the 9/11 hijackers. The explosive allegations are contained in a secret section of a report on the terror attacks known as the 28 pages.
Saudi Arabia says in a statement, quote, the CBS 60 Minutes program was a compilation of myths and erroneous charges that have been thoroughly addressed, not just by the Saudi government, but also by the 9/11 Commission and the U.S. courts. But former members of Congress who have read the document told Steve Kroft on last night's 60 Minutes the 28 pages point to a possible Saudi link. They want the Obama administration to declassify the report.
So this is your office?
Bob Graham won't discuss the classified information in the 28 pages. He will say only that they outline a network of people that he believes supported the hijackers while they were in the U.S.
You believe that support came from Saudi Arabia?
Substantially.
And when we say the Saudis, you mean the government, rich people in the country, charities?
All of the above.
Graham and others believe the Saudi role has been soft-pedaled to protect a delicate relationship with a complicated kingdom where the rulers, royalty, riches, and religion are all deeply intertwined in its institutions.
The committee will be in order.
Porter Goss, who was Graham's Republican co-chairman on the House side of the joint inquiry and later director of the CIA, also felt strongly that an uncensored version of the 28 pages should be included in the final report. The two men made their case to the FBI and its then-director, Robert Mueller, in a face-to-face meeting.
They pushed back very hard on the 28 pages, and they said, no, that cannot be unclassified at this time.
Did you happen to ask the FBI director why it was classified?
We did in a general way, and the answer was because we said so and it needs to be classified.
60 Minutes reports the White House is reviewing whether to declassify the 28 pages. The president will travel to Saudi Arabia later this month.